Hello all. We learned about absolute XPath in our first tutorial of locators in web application testing. In the second tutorial of locators in web application testing, we learned about relative XPath. In continuation to that, we will learn about relative XPath, the different methods used in relative XPath, different conditional operators used in the relative XPath to strengthen the XPath and use it in the automation testing. So let's start learning. So let's revise once the relative XPath. I will log into the application and go inside the application. In this application, now we will search one of the web object or web element. So if I want to select or search for this web element, I clicked on this using the inspect element and it has highlighted this row in blue color. So I will go here. I have opened this drop down and it shows this as input type radio, name programs. These are the attributes, as I told you, type, name, ID, value. These are the attributes of this radio button. Now, let's create the relative XPath for this radio button. So, slash slash, the tag is input. I will use the value as the attribute. And it is searching for the radio button. Now, if I select radio type as the attribute, so if I write here type and give the value as radio, then it searches for three elements, 1, 2, and 3. So that is the reason your XPath should contain the attribute which is unique, the uniquely identified attribute. So you need to think which attribute can be unique in this. Type attribute cannot be unique because there are three radio buttons, and for all three radio buttons, the type will be same. Name can be different or can be same. So we need to check name is same or no. Here it is same, name programs, so we cannot use it. Again, ID. ID generally is given as the unique identifier. Here, ID radio program Medicare is given for this Medicare radio button. And for the Medicaid radio button, the radio program Medicaid ID is given. So the IDs are different. We can use ID as the identifier, or we can use the value as the identifier, as the values of radio buttons given here are different. What we learn is we have to identify the element using the unique attributes. Now we will use one method over here, that is contains, to strengthen relative XPath. Generally, contains method is used whenever there is dynamic attribute value. To use this contains method, we have to use the opening and closing round brackets before and after the attribute and its value. So at the rate type, and instead of this equal, we will use comma. And this contains attribute is used generally for the dynamic attributes. So what is mean by dynamic attribute values? It means that in case if this name attribute is changing from program to say program 123 after the refreshing the page, then to 124, then 125, then 126. It means it changes whenever you change the page or you refresh the page. So how will we identify these kind of attributes? To identify these kind of attributes, we will use name and the initial few letters or words of that attribute value which are not changing after the refresh of the page. The numbers are changing, but the text program is not changing. So we will keep the program as it is and we will use contains method to identify our element. For now, I do not have such kind of example to show you on this web application. In automation testing, this contains method is used generally for all the types of XPaths, all XPaths identification, because it's a strong method to identify the web element or web object. Now, let's learn about one more thing regarding relative XPath, that is operators. We can use operators in relative XPath, conditional operators. So I will remove these contents and we will use the normal XPath, relative XPath, wherein I have identified the Medicare radio button with the ID attribute. I can use conditional operator over here and use one more attribute to identify this same radio button. So I will use or type, or say value is equal to Medicare. Using or attribute, it will search for our radio button with its ID or its value. If it is not able to identify with the ID, it will identify with the value. This is the OR operator, which identifies the web element with two different attributes, either ID or value. There is one more operator like this, that is AND. This AND operator, what it does is it identifies the web element with ID and value. It will not say OR. If I say ID is equal to Medicare and value is equal to Medicare 1, then it will not identify the web element. Now, if I use here OR, then it will identify the web element even if the value of that web element is incorrect, because it's searching for ID or value. But if I use AND, it will search both. ID is equal to radio program Medicare and value is equal to Medicare 1. And Medicare 1 is not available, that's why it's not searching for my web element. If I remove this 1, it identifies my web element. So we have learned about contains method, AND operator, and OR operator. Now let's learn one more method or function, that is starts with. So it starts dash with, and in the opening and closing round brackets I will give the attribute. Here I will give the attribute as ID starts with radio underscore program. What will it give me? It will give me three different web elements. Why? Because I have given starts with @ID is equal to radio program. I have given the half of the ID, not the complete ID, radio program underscore Medicare, because Medicare is the identifying keyword for this web element. For Medicaid, there is the ID radio program Medicaid. So if I say here starts with at the red ID radio program, it shows me three elements. Now you will say, why to use these kind of methods? Like contents, starts with is also one of the method. Why to use this? Again, to identify the dynamic web elements. For example, if this radio program contains dynamic IDs or dynamic values in front of it, then we can just use starts with and few of the letters which are common, then it will identify the unique element for us. For now, I do not have the example of such element. Sometimes we have to identify these elements with their text. So how to identify these elements with the text? Example here is, if I want to identify this facility combo box, but not the combo box, its label. So its label has the text facility. For that, I will use here label because it's label tag, and I will use text, but text is not the attribute. So we will not use @ over here, and we will give the value facility. This is the value of text, and instead of comma, I will use equal to. And it's finding the facility text. So you can find the text, or you can create the XPath for text or labels on the web application to search the label or the text on the web application. So this way you can create the XPath to find the label or the text on the web application using the text attribute. We can also use some access methods in relative XPaths to find some complex web elements. So I will take an example of this book appointment button. If I want to search this book appointment button, I will write here slash and tag. Now it has ID, type, and the text. So I will use type. So button in the bracket @ type is equal to submit. And I will use again double slash and ancestor method. After this ancestor method, I will use 2 times colon, and I will give the value. Ancestor means it will select all the parent tags of this button element. So I will use div because it is in the div tag. So if I use div, it gives me 4 elements after using ancestor access method. It gives me 4 elements which it has found under div ancestor having button @ type attribute having the value submit. You can use ancestor or you can use child access. This access also works or finds the child web element below this element. Now this button element does not have the child element. These kind of methods we use generally to find the values from the tables, web tables. So ancestor, child, or preceding, these are the method which gives us the values from the web table. So you can use these methods for the web table access. So this was about relative XPath. In the next tutorial, we will learn about CSS path. The way we have derived the XPaths for the web elements with different ways, we will learn about CSS path, finding the web element using the CSS path. If you are new to this channel, through Tech Talks and would like to learn automation testing and the management of testing projects, then please click subscribe and bell icon below this video. Please do not forget to like and share. Thank you.